Hello friends, this is Ganesh Mane. Welcome to another video. In this video, we are going to learn about the SERP. So in this video, we are going to learn the basics about the SERP. So in this video, we are going to learn what is SERP and how can we identify a SERP. Because if we have any number like this, square root of 3, it is a SERP. But suppose if we have another number, square root of 4, this time this is not a SERP. So we have to distinguish between these two. So how can we? So for that we have to know what is a SERP. We have to understand what is the SERP. And for that we must have the basics clear. So in this video we are only going to learn the concept SERP. And apart from the definition, we are going to have three conditions. If that conditions are satisfied by any number, then it is called as a SERP. So let's make math simple. So first of all, let us have the definition. So this is the definition of SERP. If nth root of a is equal to x, where n is any integer which is greater than 1, a which is called as a radicand for a SERP, then a is a positive real number. So here we should not have a, the negative number. And the nth root of a, this number that is equal to x must be an irrational number. So if these three conditions are satisfied, then we say that nth root of a is a SERP. So this is the definition. We are not going through the definition. We are going to understand what is the concept SERP is there. So apart from the definition, we are going to now learn what is the SERP. So for that, suppose this is nth root of a is equal to x. If nth root of a is to be a SERP, then only three conditions are there which must be satisfied by this one. The first is n must be an integer greater than 1. So if n is an integer, which is the degree of this SERP, which must be greater than 1. So this is the first condition. The second condition is a must be a real number which must be a positive. So a must not be negative. And if the third condition is there, nth root of a that is equal to x. So this whole number is an irrational number, that is nth root of a is irrational number, then we call nth root of a as a SERP. So these three conditions must be satisfied. If any one of them is not satisfying by any of the number, then it is not a SERP. All the three conditions must be satisfied, then only that number is a SERP. Now let us have one example. So to understand, these are the three conditions which are written over here. Suppose if we have a number cube root of 5. So here we have to decide whether it is a SERP or not. So these are the three conditions. N, that is the order of a SERP, must be integer which is greater than 1. Here instead of n we have 3 which is greater than 1. So the first condition is satisfied. A must be a real positive number. So here 5 is there. So as we can see, 5 is a real positive number. And nth root of a, that is cube root of 5, must be an irrational number, which is obvious. So nth root of a is irrational number. So all these three conditions are satisfied. So cube root of 5 is a SERP. Now let's have another example. Square root of minus 6. So here the order of this SERP is not given, so it must be 2. So the first condition is satisfied, that is the order of that SERP is 2, which is greater than 1 and which is an integer. The second condition is a must be a positive real number, that is the radicand must be positive real number. Here radicand is minus 6, which is not a positive. So the second condition is not satisfied, that's why this is not a SERP. Then let us have another example. Cube root of 27. So again we are going to compare these two. The order of a SERP, which is 3, which is integer greater than 1. So first condition is satisfied. Second condition is the radicand, which is 27, which is a positive real number. Second condition is satisfied. And now the third condition, nth root of a must be irrational. Now in this case, we can see that cube root of 27 is 3, because cube of 3 is 27, that is 3 into 3 into 3. So in this case, as you can see, 3 is not an irrational number. As it is an integer, it is a rational number. So the third condition is not satisfied here, that's why it is also not a SERP. So we have to understand these three conditions. If these three conditions are satisfied by any number, then only that is a third. So now you can understand why square root of 3 is a third and square root of 4 is not a third, because all the three conditions are satisfied by the first number, that is the order of a third is 2, radicand is positive real number, and square root of 3 is an irrational number. That's why this is a third. And in case of the second number, that is square root of 4, only two conditions are satisfied. First two conditions are satisfied, that is order of a third is 2, radicand is a positive real number, but the third condition, that means square root of 4 is not an irrational number, because we know that square root of 4 is 2, and 2 is not irrational number, but it is a rational number. That's why here the third condition is not satisfied by the second number. That's why second number is not a third. So there is a very fine difference between these two numbers, and this can be distinguished by having these three conditions. So apart from the definition, we must understand how to determine whether the given number is a third or not. Then only we can have some various problems based on them, that is if we have to find the order relation between the thirds or various operations on thirds like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. That can be done if we can identify which is a third. If we cannot identify a third, then we cannot have any operations on a third. So this is the very important to identify a third. So this is the video for it. The aim of this video is to make you understand the third, which is very basic concept. I hope this will help you for further studies of third. So these are the some types of video by which we are going to make math simple. So if you like this attempt, if you like the content, please subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.